A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 25th March, on the front page you have India Pakistan row over Hindu sisters' abduction. So, this is a case of two sisters from the minority Hindu community in Pakistan who were abducted. So, this resulted in Ex Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj giving a statement on them, and this resulted in an online exchange of harsh words between Indian External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj and Pakistan Minister. So, this has resulted in Prime Minister Imran Khan also ordering an immediate investigation in the case, and it is in the context of how Hindu women in parts of Pakistan are being forced to convert. So that is the point being taken. Then, this is Jamaat-e-Islami pushed youth to militancy. So, there has been surge in local recruits linked to Jamaat-e-Islami is what the government says. So, this is after Jamaat-e-Islami has been put under banned organizations. We had seen this already in news. Jamaat-e-Islami and even Jammu and Kashmir Liberation Front have been banned under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. On page 2, you have scooters, bikes used as earth excavators in Mizoram. Okay. So, Comptroller and Auditor General of India has raised this issue in its report that there are anomalies in Border Area Development Program. So, the program for 2012 to 2017 has been audited by CAG, and the report said that this development here at Mizoram's border with Myanmar, earth cutting and excavation has been done with scooters, motorcycles, auto rickshaws and cars. So, it says we are doubtful of hiring of excavators. So, that is what has come forth now. So, this is laxity of the departmental officers concerned. Because payments were being done for excavation, but excavators were not used. So, you can see there. Some words and numbers might have been misheard, leading to wrong entry of registration numbers in the bills, it is said. So, officials have given this clarification on why there are discrepancies. So, of course, it is laxity of the departmental officials concerned. It is said they did not even deem necessary to ascertain the genuineness of the claims then. If they say it is wrong entry. This is on page 5. You have voting a great privilege for these Chenchus. So, this is the Chenchu tribe in Andhra Pradesh. And it is said candidates do not come here for campaigning because of the tough terrain, but these Andhra Pradesh tribals never skip voting. On page 7 you have Army's carbine procurement held up. So the case is pending with Defence Ministry even after completion of cost negotiations. So this is for fast track procurement of 93,895 close quarter carbine rifles for the army. It has been delayed even after completion of cost negotiations. It is pending, said to be pending with the Defence Ministry. So here you can see it was in January 2018 that the Defence Acquisition Council approved this purchase of assault rifles and carbines through the fast track procurement route. So it was 6 or of US, which was the lowest bidder for the assault rifles, and UAE based Karakal for the carbines. So, agreement with 6 war has been signed of 6 war of USA, but then this agreement with UAE based company Karakil has not been signed yet for the carbines. A carbine is actually a light assault rifle. This is Rishikulya waits for Olive Ridley's. So, by now you should know Rishikulya beach in Ganjam district of Odisha is known for the Olive Ridley turtles which come here. So, this time it has been delayed, it is said, and it is said climate could be the reason for the delay. Then below you have rising sea levels to affect water table in Tamil Nadu. So, fresh water will be replaced with saline water over time according to a study. So, these rising sea levels will affect the water table. It's a study in Tamil Nadu. Then this is Protect Ocean Ecosystem, Tap Blue Economy is what Venkaiah Naidu, the Vice President of India, says. Initiate programs to harness ocean reserves sustainably. So he was addressing the National Institute of Oceanography students and officials at this institute in Goa. On the editorial page, the first editorial is 12 years later. So this is regarding the Dinakaran case, which we have discussed in news. So it was 12 years later now that Madras High Court gave its judgment overturning the trial court's acquittal and has convicted the accused. Then below you have a different league. So this is regarding IPL in its 12th iteration. It's the 12th IPL season. And it says IPL feels concerns about its place in the cricket calendar. That when IPL is taking place. Then the lead article is another look at fiscal transfers. So this article argues that time has come to amend the constitution to fix the proportion of shareable taxes for the states. So every time finance commission decides what would be the ratio of taxable income share between center and states. So this is saying to fix this proportion. And this is parallel tracks on trade ties. So economic diplomacy, it says, can still prevent the removal of US trade benefits to Indian exports. So we have already seen India has been removed from the benefits which it has under generalized system of preferences program. So India's exports were not having any duties on them. So this benefit has been removed for India. But then this article argues that if economic diplomacy is put into effect, the harmful effects or the adverse consequences of this GSP case, that India has lost the GS beneficiary status, will be nullified. Then on the op-ed page here you have, disinformation is everywhere in India. It says it is not only social media that is responsible for it, but also news media and some politicians. Then on international page you have, stricken Norwegian ship reaches port after airlift rescue. So this was a cruise liner that ran into trouble in stormy seas of Norway. And I can see 460 of its 1,373 passengers were taken off by helicopters before the vessel's engine restarted. And this is, Indian origin Labour MP faces vote of no confidence. So this is Indian origin member of parliament, Virendra Sharma. So he is in the midst of a local political storm following a vote of no confidence in him by the local constituency Labour Party. Here you can see. So it is because of his various viewpoints. So it is said that a number of concerns have been raised about his ability to represent the local community. So his failure to attend local constituency labor meetings for the past 21 months, and also concerns regarding his stance on a number of political and international issues, such as his position on issues related to Kashmir and India-Pakistan bilateral relations, etc. So in parliament, he referred to Pakistan as world's leading sponsor of terrorism. So such statements, subsequently he had to issue an apology to the local community. As such, because in UK there are the community there, there are from various religions, so, and various nationalities too. Then below you have, Ranil lays foundation stone for oil refinery. So this is a Singapore firm which is linked to an Indian business which has invested in the project, the oil refinery project at in Sri Lanka. So the foundation stone for this $4 billion oil refinery in Hambantota port region, town of Hambantota, has been laid. Then on business page here you have, hungry for energy. So this is regarding India's fuel demand, how it has increased. And here you can see this is showing the demand for various fuels like diesel, petrol, LPG. And their demand over the years, LPG, petrol, diesel, each one of them is also separately shown here. How, the demand has increased over the years and months too. The price variation over the months. Then there is no important news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com in the current affairs section. So here you can download the current affairs PDFs for daily PDFs, plus also you can enroll for a current affairs course. The details of the course are provided here. So this is detailed current affairs video course, and here you can see here you can download every day's PDF here. So that is it. Thank you.